fellas, hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. It's Friday and I ain't shot a video all week. Made some dishes, but oh well. Today, I'm gonna make some hamburgers on the stovetop because my stovetop's dirty and it's hot as hell outside. Air conditioning inside, that'd be better. But I'm gonna take a twist on mine at least. I'm going to make a Kengsington Club Marinated Burger. And I've cut the marinade, the steak and ales, Kengsington Club Marinade recipe down 1/4 of its original size because it's enough to do 5 pounds of meat. And steak mainly that you marinate overnight, but I don't think a burger is going to take that long. And, back in the, when I was in high school and a little further on after I got out of high school, it was a cool place to take a date. It was kind of intimate. It was better than McDonald's, you know. But that was the place you took your steady girl. McDonald's, Burger King, that kind of thing. But I've got some fond memories of the place. And that was my favorite item that they had there, the Kengsington Club in the salad bar, naturally. And I've made the Kengsington Club steak before a good while back on my channel, but I want to try it as a burger. Number one, because I should have started it yesterday if I was going to do a steak, because it's got to marinate 24 hours. The thicker cut meats, and they actually use a center cut sirloin. I've done it with a filet. And I think I've also done it with a ribeye, a thick-cut ribeye, and it worked well. So the recipe's pretty damn accurate. And I hear they're making a comeback because they closed about 10 years ago. Actually, they closed here longer than that ago, but I think they closed most of the stores in the United States. And they're owned by the people that own Bennigan's, too. And from what I understand, they're gonna come back and start franchising out again, which was nice because it was a cool place. It's kind of intimate, in other words, you know, English pub kind of deal. All kind of cool craft beers and all kind of good beer. Yeah, that was the thing I remember. And wines too. Anyway, so let's get started. I got a bill of marinade first, and I'll let the recipe kind of scroll slowly over this while I'm making it. Like I said, it's 1/4 the original amount, but I'm gonna put the full amount on the scroll over. Okay, so what we got is granulated garlic that I keep in my pepper grinder, and I ground up 1 teaspoon. I've got 1/4 cup of dry sherry. That's good stuff. 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1 ounce of red wine vinegar, 1 can of pineapple juice, and it's 1 ounce shy. It's supposed to be this is 6 ounces. I really needed 7. We also need 1/4 cup of soy. And this is organic soy. It's better, don't have all crap in it that just plain old soy sauce does. And keep your soy in the refrigerator because it does lose its, boy, that stuff tastes way better than the other stuff. Not the sherry. The plain old soy. So, I'm going to let this come together, give it a stir around, then we're going to put this on a hamburger, let it marinate for probably not too long, about 30 minutes or so. See how it tastes right now. I know them flavors got to come together though. Then you salt and pepper the outside of your burger is like normal. Got some kick. Yum. I'm also going to use my air fryer to do some fresh cut French fries. I used frozen last time and they come out pretty good. I want to try it with fresh cut. It gives the recipe for that too. We'll see. It's been doing good. I've tried it on several other things. It did excellent job. Excellent. On these small batch items, it does actually better than my convection oven. For small batch. I know you couldn't roast a turkey in it. It ain't that big. But I bet you could roast a smaller chicken in it. You know, whole-sized chicken. And it'd probably come out just fine. So, go ahead and chop them up to where they'll fit in my potato peeler. Which you can get them about anywhere, Amazon. I think I got this at Academy Sports here in town. And that water's been salted. It's got a good bit of salt in it. Gonna let them soak in there. And go ahead and form us up two patties. So that's 1 pound of meat. Gonna be half pound burgers. There's mine. I'm gonna pour some of the marinade on it. I poured the rest of the marinade in a pot on the stove and it's reducing. And I'm gonna reduce it way down. You'll see what we're going to do with it later. That was Miss JB's. And I've drained these several times. I'm getting all the water out of them. You can use a paper towel if you don't have one of these. Or a clean towel and drain them, get them dry. Calls for 2 tablespoons of Earl. I'm going to let it come up to heat. It says put it on power setting number 4, which is 400 degrees. Duh. All right, so there's the Earl. There go the taters. And we're going to set the timer and let it go. Go, boy, go. No? Here it is, almost done. Just checking on. Looking good. Keep going. Go ahead and fry. Mine that's been marinating. Already did Miss JB's, it wasn't on camera. And hers in the oven on warm. And damn is. And I melted some blue cheese and Irish butter. Imported Irish butter. High fat butter, let's state. Yum. Put that on my burger. And that reduced. There it is there. Some of it. On that mater. Got a little mayonnaise on that bun. Mine ass, your ass, whatever. These potatoes came out spot on perfect. Crispy, crunchy, fluffy in the middle, delicious. Damn fine. There's that reduction. That marinade reduction, back of a spoon. Just pour that marinade all over every damn thing. Oh, that was some fine. This weren't even keeper recipes. Oh, hell yeah.
On the air fryer, I was thinking, what about making a roux in it? Because basically it's a convection oven on steroids with a paddle in it that stirs. But maximum temperature is only 400 degrees. And air temperature, air doesn't conduct heat as well as a fire does. So when a roux is at 300 and say 50 degrees on a stovetop, the fire has to be much hotter than that to get it there. I say much hotter. The fire's probably burning at 500 degrees, whereas that don't get hot enough to get, it'll boil water. But, it, you know, 350 water will simmer or start to boil in the oven is what I'm getting at. And doing a dry roux in it, I don't know. It'll blow flour all over the kitchen because it's got a pretty serious fan in the damn thing. Just wanted to add that in if anybody was thinking out the box like I normally do. Like, oh no, dry ruby out the question. I'd be sweeping flour up all around here and probably have some on me too and be pissed off to the highest level of pistivity. A boy, a girl, a bye.